Let's start tuning the PID controller, for example, so that we get better steady state early enough.
So we could change the PID gain values here.
Yeah.
Just default our 1, 1, and 0. So, I don't know. What do you think?
We can either
manually do it.
Yeah, we can manually try doing it, but like Michael suggested, I just inserted 5, 5, 5 for each of the gains. And if I ran my simulation, it's better than the previous.
Yeah, that's better.
Yeah.
But I bet we could do better.
Yes, it's not the best. So.
And we want the best.
Yes. And you might spend some time to find the best possible combination. But I like to use this tune button, which is which invokes a PID tuning tool. It's a part of Simulink Control Design product. Mm. And when I click that, it opens up a nice UI where it visually shows me how the signal, how the response should look like.
Okay. So just to be clear, this PID controller block is included in Simulink, but if you want to open up this automated tuning tool that's here, that's available if you have Simulink Control Design.
Exactly. Okay. And as you can see here, the dotted line is what our block is currently doing, and the solid line is how we want our block to perform. And we can adjust those the way that we want the block to perform by moving these slider values up here.
Yeah, let's make it a little faster.
Yeah. So that way it reaches steady state faster.
Okay.
And once we are happy with this response, we can simply click on Update Block. And I think that's the best part of this tuner. So
what is that? That changes the parameters in the block itself, right?
Yes. We had 5, 5, 5. Now it's these values.
I guess
which
we
would
weren't
have been,
that close, huh?
Yes, which would have been extremely difficult to guess for a specific response that we want to look at.
Yeah, without that tuning button, I would most likely have just kept changing values, pressing OK, pressing play,
yeah,
and just keep iterating back and forth.
Exactly.
So this just makes it easier.
Yeah.
Than doing that.
So once we have that, we can verify that in simulation whether that response is
nice. That looks good.
Showing in simulation as well for that plant we choose. So that's basically how you would look at the tune your controller and look at the results.